Hello YouTube. Today we will see an example of the k nearest neighbor algorithm. So this is the question that we have been given two attributes, durability and strength, and with the help of these two attributes we need to find if the tissue paper is good or bad, right? So this is durability and this is strength, and this is the training data set that we have, and we have to find that for durability 3 and strength 7, what will be the class of tissue paper. So with the help of the training data set we will classify the tissue paper as good or bad, right? So it's like suppose that there is a graph and all the squares over here, they belong to a class bad, and all the circles, they belong to a class good. So if there is a tissue paper, we don't know what is the class of the tissue paper. So based on the durability and strength, we'll find out that a tissue paper, whether it belongs to a bad class or whether it belongs to a good class. So for that, we need to find a distance of this point from each and every point in the graph. And based on that, we will sort the distances, and then we'll find then if this point belongs to this class or is it belong to this class, that whether it belongs to bad class or whether it belongs to good class. So how can we find the distance between the two points? So we'll use the Euclidean formula. So suppose there is a point and its coordinates are x2 comma y2, and there is this point coordinates are x1 comma y1. So the distance between the two points will be how much? It's like x1 minus x2 the whole square plus y1 minus y2 the whole square, and this is how we will find the distance. So what we have to do now, we have to find the distance of this and this with each and every point, that is each and every point which is present in the training data set. So we'll find the distance of 3,7 with 7,7, 3,7 with 7,4, 3,7 with 3,4, and 3,7 with 1,4. So 3,7 with 7,7 will be 7 minus 3 the whole square, or 7 minus 7 the whole square, and its root will be 4. So like that we will find the distance of each and every training data set. So now what we will do, now we will sort the data, this data, in the ascending order. So like we'll sort the data, we'll give a rank to it, like ascending order, thus the smallest number will give the rank as 1, and then 3.6 which is 2, then comes 4, and then comes 5. These are all the ranks that we have given over here. So basically we are sorting it, and basically we are giving it a rank, right? So based on the sorting order, we have ranked the values. Now for every value of k, we need to get the class with the majority count. So first we need to find out what will be the limit of k, that for what values of k we'll find the class count. So we'll take k as root of n, where n will be the number of samples. So in our case, n equal to 4, that is why k will be root of 4, that equal to 2. So we'll check for k equal to 1, what will happen. K equal to 1 means we have to check for rank 1, right? So for rank 1, class is good. So what will happen? Count of good will be 1, right? And count of bad will be 0 for k1. Similarly, for k equal to 2, so rank is 2, and here is also the class is good. So now this time good will be equal to 2 and bad will be still. So here good is 2 and bad is 0. And we have reached the limit 2. So for durability 3 and strength 7, right, which is the question, we had to find the class. So the count of good is more than the bad, so the class is good for this. Now consider an important note over here, that for choosing the value of k, like first of all you need to choose odd value of k for a two class problem. Here the two classes are good and bad, so if there are two classes you need to choose the odd value of k, and so there is no tie between the classes. This might not be true for all cases, but it's like if suppose the value of k is 2, it's even. So what if the good count is 1 and bad count is 1. So in that case there will be a confusion. So if count of k is more, then you can choose odd value of k to get a better classification. The second one is that it's going to depend a lot on cases. Sometimes it is best to run through each possible values of k. So that's all for today, and all the data mining algorithms are given in the description below. You can go through the playlist, and also some of the sums and questions are given in the description below. The website link is in the description below, so kindly check it, and thanks a lot.